Terve. Onko mie täällä? Hallo, hallo. Nyt kuuluu jo. Yes. Hyvää iltaa kaikille. Me ollaan Supreme Virtue ja aletaan rokkaan saman tien. I'll be fine, eka biisi. Kiitos. Seuraavan biisin nimi on Solid Hypnotize.
They come back. What the fuck are you waiting for? Take me in your rotten arms. Yeah, I'm dying, but I'm not crying. Carry
mahtavaa, kiitos. Sitten lähdetään meidän tulevaan sinkkubiisiin. Nimi on Hysterical.
Kiitos paljon. Seuraavan biisin nimi on Light Has Gone Out. Mahtavaa olla taas soittamassa. Seuraavaksi mennään sitten meidän illan ainokaiseen coveriin. Tämmönen Mary Gold-niminen biisi. Nirvana alkuperäinen esittäjä.
Thank you.
Oi, että. Tässä on elämä. Olisi vaan kiva, jos tekin olisitte täällä. Mutta mukavaa kuitenkin, että päästään soittamaan. I wish you were here. Okei, kohta viimeistä viiää. Nyt lähdetään taas vanhempaan tuotantoon. Tää on Ville sulle. I'll make you stop. Sitten lähdetään viimeiseen biisiin. On tää kyllä ollut hauskaa. Toivottavasti katsojillakin on ollut mukavaa. Kannattaa muuten pysyä linjoilla, seuraavaksi meidän jälkeen tulee aika kovia esiintyjä. Älkää menkö mihinkään. Viimeisenä biisinä viimeisimmän levyn Viimeinen kappale, Above and Beyond. Kiitos paljon. Seuraavaksi Signal to Noise.
All right, hello. Welcome to the Rovaniemi Rock Academy Monda stage. It's beautiful. We've been hoping to get up here since November, and we finally have made it back. And it's winter time. This is the Santa Claus Christmas city of Europe and of the world even. And really happy to be here. Want to start by thanking Miko for being patient throughout this whole rescheduling, canceling, rescheduling. Welcome to the stream. Thank you for the great guys that warmed up the stage. It's all melting already. And we're going to get up here and play in a few minutes, but we're going to take a few minutes first to talk about what we're doing as a two-piece band, as a power duo, is what I like to call it. That's a tip of the hat to power trios like Rush, Cream, lots of great power trios, Jimi Hendrix over the years. You can consider Led Zeppelin a power trio with a singer, but a power trio is usually just instrumental players with more than one guy singing. So a band that I played with for a long, long time called Run 21 before I joined Wasp was the quintessential power trio. We were even a theatrical power trio, so we learned how to perform and kind of put on a show as a trio, as only three guys. And I wanted to start this little talk about Run 21 with speaking about Run 21, because as a trio, like the guys that opened the band and opened the show here earlier, if you saw them, they were excellent. You only have one bass player and one guitarist and a drummer. So lots of bands have two guitar players, of course. Lots of bands have three guitar players, like Lynyrd Skynyrd and Allman Brothers, and a lot of cool bands have three guitar players. But we only have one guitar player. So power trios like Van Halen and Rush are always trying to, not always, but sometimes trying to fill up that empty space, to fill up the hole, to fill up the gap. The first thing I want to show that we use in our power duo is something that we started using in our power trio, in our trio. We use these in our trio to fill up the sound. And what it is a simple synthesizer that does not have a keyboard for playing with your hands. It's just a synthesizer where the sounds are in here. Instead of playing with our hands and instead of having a keyboard player in the band, which we didn't want, we have these on the floor, and they're simply pedals that you play with your feet. And they can trigger the synthesizer. And I've got it set on the sound right now, which is pretty nice to show. So, as a band with only three guys, having a bass player or someone who would use these a little bit, in Rush, both the bass player and the guitar player would use these to trigger some sounds underneath the guitar solo or during different parts of the song. To have these really can fill out the sound. So, that sound we don't use in any of our songs right now because it's kind of a whole song, but I'll just show you quickly. We're going to use this sound. We'll use that in the music, and we'll also use this one, which is really cool. So the reason I wanted to spend a minute on showing you the system is because so many bands these days just run backing tracks. They go into the studio and record their music to a click. So when they go to play live, they simply run the studio tracks and play with them. And that's great and works fine for most bands. For us as a power duo, we want to be able to stretch out and change tempo and change key. We want to be able to stop in the middle of one song and go right to another song if we feel like it. Those kind of things you can do if you're not tied to any machines per se. So this thing allows us to have extra sounds without being tied to any machines that we have to play to them. And in our power trio, when we only had three guys, this really made a difference because I could play lead guitar and play melodic lead guitar over something with chords and something with minor chords and major chords. And we're able to do that by programming a whole chord off of one sound, which you can do with that system. All right, so that's one thing I wanted to talk about that we use in Signal to Noise with our Power Duo. The next thing that I'm going to show you is another step that we took in the Power Trio to help fill out our sound. I wanted my bass player to be able to add guitar sounds or guitar notes sometimes. So I built an instrument for my bass player that had guitar strings on it right next to his bass strings. And I'm going to go get this instrument right now. This is exactly the one I built for him way back in the day. And I ended up learning how to play it and using it and building all of the songs of Signal to Noise around that instrument. Just to summarize, though, it's simply like a 12-string guitar. It's simply like having two strings that you press down with your finger at once. One string is the bass string, and the other string is the guitar string. Once we figured out a way to get the guitar string to go to a different amplifier, which it does, it goes to the guitar amplifier, then we had a way that my bass player could add some guitar notes with my guitar. And that was really cool, and it made our trio have even another step towards sounding like a bigger band. Not that that was the only reason we did it. We didn't only want to sound like a band with another guitar player. We wanted to sound like a trio, but we wanted to be able to add sounds and not be limited. So here's this instrument. It's called the Guitar Cross. I named it the Guitar Cross because I love motocross. This is simply a bass guitar that had four strings on it, and I put a guitar string next to each of the four. Replaced the top bass string. Well, maybe not nobody. But we didn't need the top bass string. And by ditching the top bass string, the G string, we were able to add another guitar string. So I ended up with three bass strings, E, A, and D, but we usually tune this one down to D anyway. So it's D, A, and D. And we ended up with five guitar strings, D, A, D, G, B. And what that does is really opens up the fullness of chords that you can play on it. You can play almost full chords. I mean, a guitar has six or seven strings on it, sometimes eight. But to be able to have five strings lets me play most of the things that I've been able to write on regular guitar. I'm able to adopt it to this. So a lot of the songs that we'll play tonight with Thomas and with the Signal to Noise are written on a normal guitar, and they can be played by a normal band with a bass player and a regular guitar. But it's much more fun to play it on this contraption. So I'm going to put the mic down, and I'm going to turn this thing on and just show you the sounds one by one, how this thing works, and then we will get Thomas up here to talk about his drums for a minute. But I'm going to put this mic down, so be right back. So now I can talk into this mic. All right, so this thing is basically a bass and a guitar. It's got two outputs, and I kind of think about it like a regular acoustic guitar, even though it has the two systems in it. First, here's the bass. Oh, where's the bass? I got to unmute it. Here's the bass. Now, normally I'm playing with a pick, so the pick is hitting the guitar string first and then the bass string. Here's the guitar sound. So I've got different sounds I can use. Here's a clean sound. Gonna get that bass note in. That's bass and clean guitar sound. Bass and dirty guitar sound.
Now that's just really simple one string kind of strumming and riffing, but we've developed it to have you know, different techniques I can play on. I can tap on it, I can finger pick, I can do bass style things where you're using your kind of bass finger picking, and you can do double picking with the bass with the pick and everything. So that's kind of where this thing begins, and we will demonstrate it a lot further. Thomas will come up and talk about his drums, and then we're going to play kind of an instrumental song that is not part of our normal set, and we'll play that for you. But just wanted to go over this. When it was used in the Power Trio, which was right at the very beginning of when it worked, the bass player was able to kind of add, he could add, you know, under with the bass. He could be doing that under me playing lead guitar. So that was a really cool thing to be able to do, and that's where the idea began. And then I moved away from my bass player, couldn't find a bass player. So I'm like, well, it's kind of big, but maybe I'll just try to fucking play it. And it is big. For a guitar player, my fingers aren't really made for bass, but bass players would be able to really manhandle this thing. But it's really fun to try to adopt the guitar techniques onto such a weird long scale instrument. I mean, this is a 34-inch scale with a guitar string on it. So the guitar string's tight. It's very tight and it's very long. It has a really cool sound because it is very tight and very long. That's why the clean sounds are pretty nice. The clean sounds are very bell-like and very piano-like. But the disadvantage is you can't reach very far because the frets are so big. So between being able to use this and being able to use the bass string and the guitar string and to sing, all this whole thing becomes is sort of like playing a song on an acoustic guitar, except you have more sounds to work with. So that's really where this power duo ends up. We're two guys, but we're basically playing songs just like any four or five piece, but the advantage is only two of our brains that have to fight with each other. So that's a good advantage. We can kind of get things accomplished quicker without the third mind kind of having an opinion. There's less gear to move around, and it's actually a lot of fun in the improv, kind of take it wherever we want to and not have to stay to a grid. We don't have to play the song the same way every night. We can kind of stretch and move around, and that's really the big part of the fun of it. We'll play regular lead guitar a lot, and that's amazingly challenging and kind of accomplishment too. Kind of a great feeling to play lead guitar for people, but this is a wonderful way to deliver songs in a really simple way, almost like an acoustic. So without anyone here to ask any questions, normally we've been doing this kind of clinic discussion and there's musicians to be able to throw questions and talk about things. So there's no one here except you cool people in the room. But they're all working hard on tech stuff, yeah. They're all making the stream look good. So yeah, without any questions, and without any further ado, I will invite my partner in crime to get up here and talk a little bit in Finnish about his role on the drums in Signal to Noise and in a power duo, and about his role in Santa Cruz. Both of us, of course, have been, you know, everything's been canceled, so we've been able to work on this project, which is actually a really great thing, but we'll both have to eventually get back to our bigger gigs and get back to our normal roles. So this is a really great opportunity to come up and even get a chance to play. I have to say for one split second here that today is the 1 year anniversary of when the fucking thing shut down completely. Last March 13th, we had 25 shows in every town, and of course, every single one of them was off. So it's amazingly bittersweet to be up here and get to play for you guys and get to play on stage and kind of go through the motions. We've got our new backdrop that we've never used before. It's been boxed up waiting to be used. So we have our Signal to Noise backdrop, a great system in here. If only there were 150, 200 people in this room, which would be great. So thank you. Come on up, Toxie. get your butt up here, and it's your turn. And again, if you have any questions, send them an email. But that's how this thing works, and we're going to play our set. This guy does a little jabbering. This is Tomas Toksilehtinen, former Turku Rock Academy intern. That's where I met him. And we heard him play drums, and we all said, yeah, let's get him. Let's get him in our band. Yeah, let's get him. And I had to wait. I had to wait for some other bands.
Yeah.
And then I had to wait for Santa Cruz to have a break. But so we get a chance to play. All right. When you're ready, let me know, and we'll play Shuffle Kings.
Oh, right now.
You want to play it first?
Yeah.
You do? All right, we'll play this first, and then he'll talk.
Yeah.
What? All over? Oh, okay, then let's do that. All right, we're going to have a break, and then we'll start it again.
Okay.